With the concept of virtual reality, one can explain the paradoxes at the root of both relativity theory and quantum theory. The relativity theory is the easiest, and that is, in a virtual reality, you must have a delta t, which is a quantum of time, and a delta x, which is a quantum of distance. Actually, in a 3D virtual reality, you'll have a quantum of volume, but that then can be reduced to a quantum of distance. And these two quanta will define the upper speed limit of this virtual reality. In other words, anything can move no faster than one delta x per delta t if it is to be contiguous motion from one pixel to the next to the next. That is then the upper speed limit. Nothing can exceed that without teleporting, that is, jumping across pixels. So that's a very simple thing to understand. All virtual realities have upper speed limits, the things that can move. Even our virtual reality games have upper speed limits based on their delta X's and delta T's, their resolution of that game. Okay, now quantum physics was a little more difficult, but a virtual reality to be functional, to be computable, such that it's not an impossible job to do it, has to be a top-down probabilistic simulation. That's the only approach that makes it possible to do. So if you have a top-down probabilistic simulation, then everything, all matter, all interactions, tend to be described in terms of probability, at least all macro interactions, and many even of the micro interactions will be described by probability distributions. So that tells us why a particle can best be described with a probability distribution, because in a virtual reality that's a top-down probabilistic model, that's what they're made of. That's what all our interactions are made of. Probability is the instrument that defines change, how things interact, how things connect. So it's just natural that particles should be described as probability distributions. And that is the key idea that is foundational to quantum mechanics.